الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثات بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Greet you all with a greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series concerning Al-Adhkar, Remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all time, in every occasion. And this segment number 28, inshallah, this segment number 28, what you're supposed to say after you finish eating. And we're going to be working on hadith number 180. 180. Invocation after eating. الحمد لله الذي أطعمني هذا ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, this is one of the أذكار, remembrance of Allah that he used to say after he finished eating. And as I stated before, sometimes in the same occasion, you found there is more than one dua or more than one zikr. And we can learn from this how much the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to be remembering Allah in. And in learning different dua and different things, different dhikr, we see also how the Prophet ﷺ used to select special words to remember Allah, to praise Him. And the praise is only due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because no one can be more kind or more generous than Allah. And even if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't give us anything, we're still praising Him because He has all good attributes. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one that is perfect and complete in a full sense. And part of this, as example, the statement of Allah, لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. No slumber, no sleep takes over Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also that He is al-hayy al-qayyum. He is the living self-subsistence. Everything depends on Allah, but Allah doesn't depend on anyone. So we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala due to the fact that He possesses all qualities of Lordship and Godship. And this is Alhamd, why we praise Allah. And the Hamd is greater than the Shukr and the thanks. So we say after we eat, Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amani hadha wa razaqanihi min ghayri hawlin minni wa la quwwa, which means all praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who has given me this food and sustained me with it, though I was unable to do it and powerless. So you praise Allah that He fed you, gave you this food, and He provided for you, make it available for you. You may go to Food Lion or Walmart or wherever you go shopping and buy, but your money could not make the food. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the ground, makes the land, fertilize, how He sends the rain, how He causes the seeds to be splitting and the food coming. So this is something else greater than that you have some money and you go buying the food. All your money could not make this food comes out of the ground. So the praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He had fed you, give you the ability to show the food. Okay? At'amani hadha wa razaqani. He gave you the ability that you'll be able to eat it, and He had provided for you. And you say, min ghayra hawlin minni wa la quwwa, without any power from me or mighty. Because for the food to exist, it needs a lot. It needs the power, it needs the mighty, it needs the wisdom. We could not cause the rain to come down. We could not cause the seed to split and for the green to come out of it. So you're saying that Allah had provided this food for me and gave it to me, gave me the ability to chew it, to eat it, to digest it, okay? And I am powerless. My little bit power, ability could not make the food, could not make the food grow. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this. If a person could not say all these words, at least say Alhamdulillah. Okay? But you always have to learn how to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the best fashion and the best manner. So in this dua is saying, Alhamdulillah alladhi. Alhamdulillah alladhi. Praise due to Allah. Alhamd is praise. Lillahi means for Allah or to Allah. Alladhi, who at'amani, fed me. Hada, thus, and this returning or referring to the food. Wa razaqanihi, from the rizq, provision, provided. Wa razaqanihi, min ghayr hawlin, with no ghayr, with no or without hawl, mighty, minni, from me, wala quwwah, wala, no power, no mighty, no, like you say, la hawla wala quwwata illa billah. And this is one of the most powerful dhikr. La
Yep.
hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Okay? So he's saying that he gave me this food, provided for me, with no power or mighty from me. Min ghayri hawlin minni wa la quwwa. Min ghayri hawlin wa la quwwa. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Okay? So the dua will go like this. Alhamdulillahi alladhi. At'amani. Hada. Wa razaqanihi. ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة الحمد لله الذي أطعمني هذا ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة الحمد لله الذي أطعمني هذا ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة الحمد لله الذي أطعمني هذا ورزقنيه من غير حول مني ولا قوة. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this morning. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Islam. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for give us the mighty and the ability that we come to the salah. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for give us the opportunity to sit in his house. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and praise him for giving us the opportunity that we pray Fajr in Jama'ah. We thank Allah for everything, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala worthy of praise as much as we say and more than what we say. Ameen. آخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. Any question, comments, correction? سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. It's okay, maybe somebody came late. Those people who lives in Colombia and they are not coming to Jum'ah, I want to see you tomorrow, inshallah. Tomorrow. And you know who I'm talking about. Yeah, I see you only in the Facebook. You need to be here for Jum'ah tomorrow.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. All right. Have a good day, everybody. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you so much.